गुड मॉर्निंग मैम, माय नेम इज़ अहद शेख एंड आवर ग्रुप नेम इज़ द अंडर डॉग्स। वी आर प्रेजेंटिंग द बिजनेस फ्रॉम कोका कोला। स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द कोका कोला कंपनी इज़ एन अमेरिकन मल्टीनेशनल बेवरेज कॉरपोरेशन हेडक्वार्टर्ड इन अटलांटा जॉर्जिया। द कोका कोला कंपनी हैज़ इंटरेस्ट इन द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग रिटेलिंग एंड मार्केटिंग ऑफ नॉन अल्कोहलिक बेवरेज कॉन्सेंट्रेट्स एंड सिरप्स। द कंपनी वॉज फाउंड ऑन 29th of January 1892। The second slide represent the history of the Coca-Cola. The Coca-Cola history began in 1886 when the curiosity of an Atlanta pharmacist, Dr. John S. Pemberton, led him to create a distinctive tasting soft drink. The pharmacist invented the Coca-Cola drink as drug which was helpful in relief of headache. The pharmacist bookkeeper, Frank Robinson, is credited with the naming product and creating its logo. Coca is equal to leaves, cola is equal to nuts. American businessman Asag Candler completed his purchase of Coca-Cola formula and brand. The further slides will be explained by Sohil.
My name is Sohil Sayed and I am going to present the diagram of supply chain according to Coca-Cola. Packaging, ingredient, marketing, distribution, retailers, vending machine, and finally it goes to consumer. And after consumer consumes the product, it goes to recycle and then landfill. Supply chain management of Coca-Cola. Supply chain management is a process that used by companies to make sure that their supply chain is efficient and coefficient. The five basic components of supply chain management is planning, development, manufacture, distribution, and return. The supply chain goes again and again. Now further explanation. Arham will continue.
Hello ma'am, this is Arham Afrad and my group name is The Underdog. I am here to explain the slide supply chain risk management. In supply chain management process, there is a risk of demand, supply and inventory problems and risk on. To manage this risk, Coca-Cola maintain good relation with distributor, wholesaler and the retailers. Information technology plays a virtual role for increasing collaboration among the change management. In second slide, we can see the process of Coca-Cola and supply. So how supply chain network works are connected. Market planning, sales order, manufacture, transport, then for dispatch, warehousing, bulk deliveries, retailer, and finally to the consumer.
My name is Ilyas Khan. Retailers and wholesalers. Wholesalers are called distributors. There is sub-distributor of Coca-Cola has were responsible for delivering stock of Cokes to those places and areas where trucks can't afford to travel. Well, after the retailers and wholesalers, let's move on to the components and raw materials used. Well, in the manufacturing of Coca-Cola, process goes from the concentrated formula to the dilution and the processing of formula, addition of water, sugar, carbon dioxide, etc. And there is the addition of supply of sugar from own plant, and then it moves on to the bottling in own plants, to the regional dealers, to the local dealers, local shops, and then finally to the consumers. Let's move on to the final conclusion. The Coca-Cola company is profitable firm in short and long term investment. The profit margin is high and they are in the position to pay their debts in their resources. Undoubtedly, the Coca-Cola company has developed all the elements necessary to run a multi-million worldwide enterprise and refreshes all the people that comes in contact with the products. Well, finally, I would like to thank my friends Ahad Sheikh, Sohail Sheikh, Aram Afrad, and thank you ma'am.